Hello, Gasplagaga here, talking about a new already confirmed structure deck, Surge of Divine Radiance or Surge of Divine Light, how some people call it in this video. So this structure deck will be released in the OCG in September. In this video I will talk about already known cards, the effects of potential other new cards, already confirmed reprints and my speculations on unconfirmed reprints. One last thing before we start, I have to take the loss right here and address the elephant in the room kinda. I made a very similar video a few months ago speculating about a potential new Earth structure deck. Unfortunately, I overlooked one very important detail during my research for that particular video. That detail being the fact that we never got a Light and Darkness structure deck back in the day in the TCG, because somebody thought it would be a good idea to give us those cards in the booster sets instead, in Strike of Neos and Force of the Breaker, but not as commons or rares, but all as secret rares. So because of that dick move, I completely forgot to take those structure decks into consideration. Fortunately, my video is still not wrong. The structure deck will simply be delayed, so maybe in 2018 we could see such an Earth structure deck. But enough justifying myself, let's talk about the Light structure deck. There are already 12 confirmed cards. Keep in mind this is the OCG version. A few cards could be exchanged when the deck comes to the TCG. Those cards are the new cover monster, of course, Angel Paladin Arth Pasha. Two new effect monsters, Angel's Angel Minerva, who gains attack every time a counter trap is activated and also can recover counter traps from the graveyard. Power Angel Valkyra, which can search light fairy type monsters from your deck. And next we have the old cover monster, Neo Pasha, the Sky Paladin, and some nice reprints like Nightshield, Sage of the Sky, and Hornets. Only one spell card is known so far, which is of course the Sanctuary in the Sky. I think next to Umi, probably the second most mentioned field spell in effects. And of course a lot of counter trap cards, Ultimate Providence, Drastic Drop Off, Divine Punishment, Solemn Warning and Solemn Judgment. Again, only because there's Solemn Judgment doesn't mean this card is gonna be unbanned or this card is gonna be in the TCG version of this structure deck. So what could additionally be in this structure deck? Especially when it comes to new cards. I mean, we already know that we get probably like 6 new cards, 3 revealed, 3 more to go. The distribution of cards in the other structure decks were 4 monsters, 1 spell and 1 trap card. So we are talking about one of each, a monster, spell and trap. Let's start with the most important one, which is in my opinion also the most obvious, a new version of Sanctuary in the Sky. It doesn't need to be a field spell, just a continuous spell or trap card that is treated as the Sanctuary in the Sky while it's face up on the field. I playtested with the new Counter Fairy support a lot and the deck needs so much setup to get going. That's why I really hope that the new Sanctuary in the Sky actually helps the deck in that aspect. For example, by protecting your fairies from being destroyed by battle. Doesn't seem that strong in normal decks and I would normally agree, but this is Counter Fairies where you actually want your opponent to activate effects and not to just summon a huge speed stick and run over your monster, so protecting them from being destroyed by battle is huge in such a deck. It would also be pretty close to the original, but it's 2017, so cards need at least 2 to 3 effects to be even considered being playable. In addition, the card could also have a second effect that allows you to easier summon the original Pasha. For example, by being able to special summon fairy monster from your hand or graveyard. Next, let's talk about the trap card. I think we all can agree if I say that it would make the most sense to give us a new counter trap card. So the counter trap could obviously negate spells, trap and monster effects. And if you have the Sanctuary in the Sky face up on the field, maybe you can special summon like a partial monster from your hand in addition after triggering it. But keep in mind, those are just my speculations. The other possibility is a remake of the old structure deck, exclusive trap Aegis of Gaia. The card that gives you 3000 life points as long as you control it. Pretty useless nowadays. A newer version of that card that maybe special summons fairy type monsters from the grave and increases your life points could be an option. Although I wish we could see 2 new trap cards for the deck, I think the last slot goes to a monster. And the reason why I think that is there's one additional ultra rare slot which has to be filled right now. And obviously there are 2 ultra rares which normally go to monsters. So it would make sense if that monster is like a small version of Parshath or maybe a new version of Nova Summoner. Nova Summoner is a very old card that's basically like a Verse Shining Angel. But if the Sanctuary in the Sky is face up on the field and it's destroyed by battle, you could special summon the Air Knight Pasha straight from your deck. Nice, but fortunately only the original one, so that's why I think that it could be really nice if you could get a better floating monster that could special summon or more fairies and has a wider searching range. Also the card could fill your graveyard, so you could special summon a new Paladin Pasha straight from your hand. So those are just my speculations on the new cards. Now let's talk about reprints. There are so many possibilities. Just to list a few: Harvest Angel of Wisdom, Friar, Spirit of Victory, Nova Summoner, Jalanduo, Radiant Gerald, Shining Angel, of course Air Knight Parshav himself, and a reprint that a lot of people have been waiting for: Bountiful Artemis, Voltanis, and Lyra Deliberator, which is actually kinda nice in combination with a new cover monster. Also we could get Gaidning Ariadne, Arclord Christia, Athena, Theus Goddess of Light, Zaradis Herald of Heaven, Victoria, and Hecatrice. Those are my guesses for new monster reprints. I don't expect a lot of spells to be in this deck, but Valhalla Hall of the Fallen, Cards from the Sky, and Celestial Transformation, as well as some nice reprints, could be in here. And obviously, when we come to the traps, there are a lot of counter traps like Dark Bribe, Negate Attack, Wiretap, Magic Drain, and Grand Turn of Heaven that could be here as reprints. And maybe even, if you're lucky, Solemn Strike and Recall. I think Solemn Strike is not that unlikely because it's already confirmed for some other stuff, so maybe they also throw it in this structure deck. And maybe as a non-counter trap card, we could also see a Synthetic Zephyram, a card that special summons a token every time a counter trap is activated. I'm mentioning this because there's always a token in the new structure deck, so this could be the token generator in this deck, with the artwork of the token being the artwork of this card. And another non-counter trap card could be the already mentioned Aegis of Gaia, as a throwback to the old structure deck. At the end, I want to talk about two cards in particular. One is very interesting because I don't think it's gonna be in this deck, so maybe people who wanna invest in the secondary market wanna listen up right now, because that card could actually rise up in price. And that second card is a nice idea that I have for future support in upcoming booster set to support the structure deck after its release. So let's talk about a card that I really don't think is gonna be in here, and that is Vandalgion, the Dark Dragon Lord. The fact is fitting for this deck, but the type and attribute are not. This is a light fairy structure deck, and it doesn't make sense to have a dark dragon type monster in here. So maybe you wanna buy these now before they get a little bit too expensive. The other card I wanna talk about is a new, not released counterpart of Guiding Ariadne. A scale 5 with the same effect on a field, and the pendulum effect could allow you to activate counter trap cards from your hand. That's just my idea what could be realistic as an additional support in upcoming booster sets for supporting the structure deck. So at the end, I want to give you my personal opinion on the structure deck. With the three cards known so far from the structure, I think this deck will not be relevant in the metagame. You need too much setup, and you heavily rely on Card of Demise and Tides of the Brethren to actually do something. You need too much setup, you need a fairy that benefits from activating your counter traps, obviously at least one counter trap, and access to Sanctuary in the Sky, and in the best case you also have a way to stop your opponent's attack, so have Harness in your hand or negate attack. And that's just way too much. Also surprisingly, the deck lacks good counter traps. Many counter traps have so many downsides, and that basically means that you also need Guiding Ariadne in your opening hand. And again, that's just an additional card that's very unlikely to draw those 5 cards in your opening hand. So I hope really that they do something to boost the consistency of the setup, because the deck can actually be really damn scary in the late game. Like seriously, if this deck survives a few turns, it can make so much plus and advantage, it's kinda unfair. But then again, it has such a weak start that it's actually kind of balanced. So let's just wait and see what happens with the structure deck. Also, I want to mention at this point, if you haven't seen it, there are probably a few videos out there that you can just search on YouTube. Ancient Search Minerva together with Drastic Drop-Off is such a nasty combination. You can basically Yata lock your opponent for a few turns so they can't draw from their deck. That is at one nasty combination, guys. So that's it. I really hope that they can fix the deck with the three upcoming cards. Let me know in the comments what you think about my speculations and if you agree or not. Also, don't forget to support the channel, for example, by liking this video or sharing. Hey, it's only one click, so again, thank you for watching. Till next time, bye.